Here is the Writer's Almanac for Saturday. It's the 26th of May, 2018. It's the birthday of the novelist Alan Hollinghurst, born in a little town, Stroud, England, 1954, an only child. Parents sent him off to boarding school, then went to Oxford, where he decided to try his hand at writing. His first novel, The Swimming Pool Library, came out in 1988, story of a gay man who saves the life of an older gay man, an aristocrat, a novel full of explicit descriptions of sex. Hollinghurst said, "For a shy person, it strikes me now that my first novel was rather bold, but I think shy people often have a strange compensatory impulse. When they do something, it's ridiculously outspoken." The book spent months on the bestseller list. Hollinghurst is a meticulous writer, spends years on each novel. He's published four novels since The Swimming Pool Library. The Line of Beauty in 2004 won the Booker Prize, the most recent one, The Stranger's Child. Alan Hollinghurst said, "I'm not at all easy to live with. I wish I could integrate writing into ordinary social life, but I don't seem to be able to. I could when I started. I suppose I had more energy then. Now I have to isolate myself for long periods. It's all become more of a challenge. I find writing novels gets harder and harder, which is not what I thought would happen. I thought you'd learn how to do it." It's the birthday of the horror writer Robert William Chambers, born Brooklyn, 1865, came from a prominent family, studied art in New York, exhibited paintings in Paris, and then decided that writing was his calling instead, and he published a collection of horror stories, or, as they were called at the time, weird stories, the book entitled The King in Yellow, which was extremely popular, and Chambers continued to write bestsellers, some romances, some horror stories, working every day from 10 to 6 in a New York office that even his own family didn't know the address. And it's the birthday of Miles Davis, born Alton, Illinois, 1926, his father an oral surgeon. Family lived in a nice home in East St. Louis and owned a ranch in Arkansas. Miles Davis first heard jazz on the radio. A radio show called Harlem Rhythms came on the air at 8:45 in the morning. Started music lessons, playing the trumpet, was playing professionally by the age of 15, and when he was 18, he struck out for New York to find his hero, Charlie Parker. Soon they were playing together, and in 1959, Miles Davis recorded Kind of Blue, one of the best-selling jazz records of all time. Here's a poem for today by Joy Sutphen, entitled Happiness. This was when my daughters were just children, playing on the rocky shore of the lake, their hair in braids, their bright-colored jackets tied around their waists. It was afternoon, the shadows falling away, their faces glowing with light. Whatever we said then, and it must have been happy, it must have been hopeful, is lost, as I am now lost from that life I lived. This was when nothing that I wanted mattered, though all I wanted was happiness, pure happiness, simple as strawberries and cream in a saucer, as curtains floating from a windowsill, as small pairs of shoes arranged in a row. Happiness, a poem by Joy Sutphen, from her collection First Words, published by Red Dragonfly Press, and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac, supported by the Poetry Foundation, partners with the National Arts Endowment in Poetry Out Loud, a national poetry recitation contest for high school students. You can visit poetryfoundation.org for more information. And by Barnes & Noble, maker of Nook, Simple Touch with Glow Light, designed for reading with the lights on or off, available at Barnes & Noble stores or Nook.com. Engineered by Noah Smith, be well, do good work, and keep in touch.